Financial planners, financial advisors, should you use them? Personally, I don't like them, and I'll tell you why. What's happening, guys? Again, I'm not trying to say I don't like financial planners. I'm not trying to say that I, you know, have anything against them. Personally, for me, they just don't make sense. And I think that for a lot of people in the real estate industry, I don't think that they make a lot of sense. The reason being is that if you are a real estate investor, you make your money off of finding really good deals, right? Jake and I have made our living off of finding really good deals. So again, I just personally don't want to put my money into someone else's hands where they might say, hey, you can make 5% by putting it into an IRA, or 5% by putting it into a mutual fund, or, you know, 8% or whatever. They might even say, hey, I can put it into a riskier investment for you and try to make you a higher percentage. But again, me personally, I like to stick with what I know. I know that, you know, I have a certain amount of money that I could put towards an Airbnb, or I could put it towards a long-term hold. You know, you could put it towards a multifamily unit, something like that. And again, that's just what makes sense for me personally. Again, nothing against them at all. I think it just depends on what industry you're in. I get the you know, the appeal to it if you are, I don't know, say you're a nurse, or say you're in a different industry where you're working a 9-to-5 where you don't have a lot of opportunities to just, you know, flip your funds into a new project, right? So if you're someone like that, then yeah, I understand it more. You know, let me take this money and put it into something that's nice and safe, that's going to make me 5% on my money over a year, just because you don't have as many options. But again, for people that are watching this, most of you guys are going to be financial, you guys are going to be real estate investors as well. So again, my advice is do not put your money into their hands and let them take care of it. The other thing you have to keep in mind, they make money when you make money, right? They make money when we make money by giving it to them. So I just personally like the idea of managing my own money, putting it towards the things that I know and the things that I have a better idea of what will grow it. So that's my advice for you. So again, you know, with the opportunities that Jake and I have had as of recently, you know, we could buy a property for $180,000. You could put 30 grand into it and be all into it 210. And just because of what's happening in real estate right now, that property could be worth, you know, $350,000. It could be worth $400,000. So I mean, like, you could literally make 100% on your money in the matter of, you know, 4 to 6 months versus, you know, possibly making 5%, possibly making 10%. So again, that's just where I really like real estate a lot better than the other options that are out there. Now, guys, this video is not to stir the pot with any of my financial planner friends, okay? Because I have a lot of them out there. You know I love all of you guys. Again, it's just giving my input on why I do not use a financial planner. And one last bit of advice. If you are going to take on a financial planner, before you do, you should probably look into them a little bit. You know, kind of see what they put their money into, see how they're doing in life. Because again, the last thing that I want to do is I don't want to give my money to someone where when I find out that they don't have any assets, right? They don't have their life figured out. They're living a very, you know, they're living paycheck to paycheck. If there's a financial advisor that is telling me to do one thing, yet they are living paycheck to paycheck, that is not someone I want to trust with my money. Which is another reason why, if you're looking to place your funds somewhere and you're looking to maybe make some good money on your money, believe it or not, you can invest with Jake and I at Viking Real Estate. We actually partner with many, many friends of ours that have, you know, say 20, 30, you know, all the way up to 100 grand that will invest with us in given properties, flips, long-term holds, long-term rentals, stuff like that, because we've been able to prove that we know what we're doing. So again, if any of you guys out there have any money that you're looking to partner with, you know, with someone like Jake and I on, we would gladly open that door to talking to you about it. Let us know. On that note, I love you guys. Hope you're enjoying this video still, and until next time.